that the devil is an open enemy to humanity. There is no compromise with the devil. So we don't play around and disguise ourselves as little devils, little shayateen. Baby, you can call me a superman.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Jesse Keegan, and we are Fanny and Jesse. And guys, I know I have a lot of explanation to say and stuff like that. I've not been around for a while now. It's been almost 2 weeks and something like that. And I've been kind of busy. I've been moving houses to houses. So I was trying to settle down, and again, I got a new job where I was just kind of coming in late and really tired. So I couldn't just, like, you know, do a video for you guys. Right about now, I'm settled and I'm ready to just, you know, fulfill your requests and stuff like that, guys. Thank you so much for your patience. So, I mean, I want to thank everybody, first of all. If you're new to this channel, we're Fanny and Jesse, and we do a lot of reaction videos. Just make sure to subscribe and make sure to just, you know, watch our videos that we did before and whatnot. And also, we have a new channel which is called Fanny and Jesse 2.0. We normally post there sometimes. You can just see us over there, and the link is going to be on the comment section below. We're going to pin it down there. Make sure to go and subscribe to that channel. And thank you so much, guys, once again. And right now, I'm back, and we're going to do a little reaction video. Just let me know in the comment section below if you want me to do any type of reaction videos, and I'm going to do it for you. So right about now, I'm going to do a video that was suggested by a lot of people. Everybody knows what Halloween is, and different people have their own explanation, but not everybody knows. A number of people knows what it really, really means, and other people don't know what it really, really means. You get it? So actually, today we're going to demystify what really Halloween is, like the origin of Halloween. So what we're going to do, we're going to react to The Origin of Halloween by Abdullah Hakim. And let's get to it, guys. And once again, thank you so much. And to all my Muslim brothers out there, assalamu alaikum. And let's get it.
Going to the fall season, the Celtic people of the north used to believe that during the fall season, their year began. And actually, for the Celtics, their new year's was November 1st. October 31st was the final day of the year for the Celtic people of the north. And that day was called the Day of Samhain. And this individual, Yahudah, was supposed to be their god of the spirits of the dead, of evil again. And according to their belief, the evil spirits would rise to the surface and would terrorize people on that evening. And on that evening, if you did something wrong to a person, they'd come back to get you in the night. So some people would put on a disguise, so you couldn't recognize them on October 31st on that evening. And then they would be safe. Also, they would burn fires. Now the only thing we find left of that is the jack-o'-lantern that they would put inside of their window, made from the pumpkin. What actually happened in Europe is that the church moved All Saints Day, a day for the saints. They moved it from May 13th to November 1st in 1834 AD. And so what they said was that the 31st night is All Hallows' Evening. All Hallows' Evening, which in America later became known as Halloween. Halloween. And they depict the forces of evil. What is happening now is that the children put on disguises. They dress as little devils, little witches, as goblins, vampires, anything evil, and they go out, and now with the new American way, they do trick-or-treats. And they come to your house asking for food. Do they do that here in Miami? Trick-or-treat. They knock on your door in the disguise. And some Muslims, thinking they want to be Americans, or they want to be Canadians, they send their little children, and they're in little disguises. So what are you going to dress them? A little angel? What are you going to be? How are you going to dress and walk in? And so the reality that we recognize is that, number one, this is the day of Samhain. And the Quran tells us, in the shaitan of the insanity, adu'un mubin, that the devil is an open enemy to humanity. There is no compromise with the devil. So we don't play around and disguise ourselves as little devils, little shayateen. We do not disguise ourselves as this, because it is an open enemy to the people of monotheism. Also, there are a number of other aspects. What is happening now, as you may know in America, is that there is a new church coming about, which is called the Church of Satan, or the Diablo. And in the 60s in San Francisco, the church was initiated, and right now in the American army, if you are Jewish and you die, they bring you a rabbi. If you're Muslim, they'll bring you an imam. If you're Christian, they'll bring you a priest or a minister. If you're registered as part of the Church of Satan, they bring you a priest from the Church of Satan. And he is performing these rites and rituals, calling on the devil to accept his initiates. And so this is growing in this society. And they actually did a couple movies. They did this Rosemary's Baby. Right? They also, The Exorcist. And a number of movies they did to frighten people with evil. That you would be so afraid of evil, and they show the priests as bumbling idiots, falling down on their feet, can't do anything, running away from the devil, and the devil is a businessman in his suits. He has the power of lightning and everything, so even though the devil dies in the end, you end up being more afraid of the devil than anything else. That's part of the plot, to brainwash people to be afraid of the shaitan. The reality is that the Prophet said that the upper hand is better than the lower hand. That the upper hand is better than the lower hand. What that means is you should be the one who gives and don't beg. We should not be begging. And so to send a Muslim child out to trick-or-treat is a demeaning, lowering thing. You ask them to beg people for food. Then they're dressed up in as a way that they're not. Then, when the candies and things come in the bag, how do you know what it is they actually gave you? Is it halal? Most of the candies today are made with gelatin, with glycerin. They're made with pork products. We had one person in our area, in the Boston area where I grew up. One person in our area, in our project, he used to sit back and he used to give everybody X-Lax. You know X-Lax? He give you chocolate and he puts X-Lax in the thing. And then he goes around and waits the next day to see everybody. So they can do anything to you, man. You have no control over the situation. You have no control. And what is also happening is that there are some evil, wicked-minded people who are attacking children on that night. I don't know about Miami, but in Canada now, they openly say on the television, do not send your children trick-or-treating by themselves. Do not go in darkened streets. Move as a group. Don't go to a house that you don't know the people on the inside. And there are literally groups of Satanists who are capturing children, and they're performing a rite, sacrificing the child on that evening of Samhain, supposedly to get more spiritual power. It's happening right now. And so from so many angles, Muslims should have nothing to do with Halloween. And if your children are in school, go to the teacher. Go to the teacher and make it clear to the teacher, we do not involve our children in these ceremonies, even the Jehovah's Witnesses. We'll go to the teacher and tell them, take my child out of Halloween. They don't even believe in that. Take my child even out of your Christmas. They're not involved in it. What can happen during these occasions, if you want them to draw pictures of pumpkins or, you know, fall plants, okay. But we don't want to be involved in these confused rituals that are giving signals from many different angles.
Wow. That's so amazing. I mean, first of all, I like the way he say that the devil is an open enemy for humanity. I mean, it's true anyway. I mean, the devil has been put into a context whereby we should fear him. You get it? We should he's our enemy. We should fear him. Like, it's really like evil looking type of a person and stuff like that. But I don't think we should fear the devil. We should be able to stand still and look at and be able to like rebuke or something like that. I mean, it shouldn't be that way anyway. But the origin of Halloween, I wanted to say something about it. I like the way he has explained it in a very good way. For me, Halloween really doesn't make sense to me. It's just like an evil type of thing. You get it? Why would you disguise yourself like the devil, like a little witch, like just something looking, some weird looking type of thing? You get it? And then you're celebrating it by, you know, just like making it look fun and stuff like that. It's not something that people should joke about. And again, I heard about Halloween, that's the time whereby these Satanists, they perfect their rituals and whatnot. That's the time whereby a lot of people have been sacrificed, probably just like the way he said, like, don't let your kid just go and do the trick or treat, something like that. Don't let him or her go to any house that you've never seen anybody in it. Anything can happen, you get it? Just go as a group. But again, just by sending out your kid to go and beg for candies and whatnot, just like the way he said, it's not like it's forbidden in the Quran or stuff like that, which is really, really bad. And again, you don't know what these people are giving out your kids. You don't know whether it's a candies, genuine candies, or just candies to like, you know, make your kids maybe doze off or something. You know, anything can happen during this period of time. But I really don't I don't condemn anything, but I feel like it's just evil. You get it? I feel like it's not. I mean, it looks fun, people disguising themselves and people going out there having fun and whatnot, but I feel like there's some lower type of vibration going at that particular moment, because I think that's the time where they do their rituals, and everybody who goes out there disguising themselves and the devils or whatnot, they're subjected to a lower vibration. That's when they actually probably get your energy, maybe steal your energy, maybe just use you that particular moment, which it's not a good thing. I mean, Halloween is, for my own opinion, I feel like it's not a good thing. I mean, it's something that was just created to lower down our vibration. That's what I feel about Halloween. But anyway, for the people out there who like it, I mean, it's fun. You can just go out there, have fun. But again, you have to sit down and think about it. Why am I doing this? Why am I letting my kids to go and disguise themselves as little devils or something like that? Is there any benefits from that? Or is there any conditioning? Or is there any... this world that we live in is really, really crazy. Anything that we see, anything that we do, they should have a consequence whereby there's either somebody who's benefiting out there and there's another person who's losing. You get it? So if you're doing your Halloween thing and you're disguising yourself as a devil and whatnot, and mind you, everybody's out there celebrating the Halloween thing, so you can imagine the kind of vibration that is out there and the type of rituals these people are doing. So they're actually accumulating their whole energy, and then they're using the energy for themselves to, like, for their spiritual purposes, you know, like just trying to be more powerful and powerful. That's why they're able to control this world that we live in today, just by doing so. Anyway, thank you so much for being with me on this video right here. And if you managed to come up to this end, you're the realest MVP. Thank you so much. And yeah, thank you so much. If you feel like I reacted to this video in a better way, just give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to go down my comment section. Or don't forget to go down our comment section and tell us exactly what you feel about this video, or what you feel about my reaction. Just let me know in the comment section below, man. And the most important thing, guys, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The more you keep on subscribing, the more you give us the motivation to do a lot of videos and to give you a better content. Just let me know what kind of video you want me to react to. Any type of video I'm gonna do for you guys. Any type, music type of videos, any religious type of videos, and just let me know in the comment section. I'm gonna do it for you. So right about now, I want to thank you so much for being around. And if you're new to this channel, just make sure to subscribe, make sure to hit that notification bell so that you become the first person to watch our videos. And I promise you guys, I won't go again. I'll be here with you. I'll be dropping a lot of reaction videos. And thank you so much for being with us and me. Until next time, I'm gonna see you in the next video, or rather, we're gonna see you in the next video. And peace out.